In this feature from Nevada, we travel to South Taranaki in New Zealand. We'll meet Alan Coburn, a dairy farmer who's made significant strides in his operations. Join us as he shares how Nevada's effluent system has been a game changer for his farm.
It's going to spread paddocks of effluent from the main pond, get it down a bit more. Put around a third on not so long ago, so we'll just now head up with effluent and see what happens. Hopefully, with the weather improving, she'll grow. Needs to improve. We are a 380 cow dairy farm down at Waverley. We split calve 70% for autumn, 30% for spring. Autumn calving because we're on a sandy beach type soil. We've got about 180 hectares effective. We rear all young stock on farm. We have two full-time staff, system five for feeding through the winter and mainly all year round too. Feed, we bring in maize, basic grass silage. We'll bring in PK when needed. Most bulk feeds are fed on the feed bed. Fairly flat with the odd bit of contour and hills in it. We keep a pretty simple system. We've got a 40 bar rotary. Pond size, I think we put in a 1.3 million cubic metre. We're running two Nevada pumps, one on the main pond, one also for the sump to feed the pond, one big pond stirrer for the main pond, and then we have one submersible stirrer. Then we also run one of the Nevada tankers. We've got a 12-8 tanker to spread the rest of the farm. Old effluent system was straight pump to paddock system, no storage space available. Basically, every day of the year, pump had to run. Problem through the winters, we're like, yeah, when it's wet, we're still running it. Puddles, ponding, continuous issues with breakdowns. Older system, just, yeah, time consuming. So we were shifting the irrigator up to twice a day just to keep it moving. Oh, it's a nightmare, man. When it's now raining, you've got to shift that damn thing twice in a day. Then you get those cold southerlies, it's like, yeah. I like this method. I'm in a camp. Keeps it dry. With Nevada, they designed, supplied and installed everything, which was so user-friendly. It just worked really well for us. And we went with Nevada because we could get what we wanted with a complete package through to the tanker to them getting the pond built under their management. So I was more hands off doing what I actually do best in other times of the year. Install was actually done relatively quickly. They brought in our digger crew, basically 5 days time. We had full shape of the pond. The line of crew come in, they were here for 2 days. Very simple, straightforward. From that, we installed all the travelling irrigation lines all underground, put all the hydrants in. 4 weeks later, we had the sump turn up, and then it was just wiring from there. It was basically left up to Nevada. We just carried on doing what we needed to do on the farm, and we also liked the idea because they're fairly well stocked in parts. They're local for us, which is a real important thing at times. Our biggest issue and concern with doing this would have been the pond itself, because we are majority sand-based, and building the embankment we needed to have the shape and basically keep the embankment there. We managed to actually shape it up really, really well, and we found that there was no erosion, no concern at all. Our biggest benefits will be spreading the effluent further around the farm at a very reasonable cost structure, just getting the organic matter back into the ground. The tankers are a bloody good tanker, I find, this size especially being 12-8. I find they're real easy to operate. I mean, I've actually taught my youngest to drive it, say, like she's 16, she finds it easy. I've used effluent like this before, but yeah, with the pond now, it just makes more sense. Middle of summer, we'll just suck the whole thing out and just spread it across the farm in the summer. This time of year, we'll just use it in between your air runs and see how that really works. But a bloody good machine, really.
Does it give you time to get home and have a beer?
Sure does. Definitely get home in time for beer. Yeah, no, I definitely would recommend Nevada to other people. They do a complete package and you can carry on doing what you want to do while they do what they need to do. There is no hesitation there at all.
Wrapping up on our visit to South Taranaki, we've seen firsthand the impact of Nevada's effluent system on modern farming. And thanks to Alan for offering us a glimpse into his operations. Right, until next time, we'll see you later.